Hello, thanks for attending my talk. My name is Xiao Nan, and I'm very grateful for FOSSASIA to give me the opportunity to give a speech here. In this topic, I will share a small tool, lscpu, for BSD operating systems. Okay, I will introduce myself first. Working in Data Storage Institute, also known as DSI. And personally, I like researching technologies related to computer infrastructure, such as operating system kernel, concurrent programming, debugging, etc. And since I'm not a native English speaker, so please forgive me poor oral English and grammar errors in both talk and slides. Okay, this is the agenda of today's talk. Firstly, I will introduce how I begin my journey with BSD operating systems. Then I will introduce how lscpu is implemented in Linux operating system. Then I will introduce how I implement lscpu for BSD operating systems. Okay. Let's enter the section why I choose to use BSD operating system. Okay, before talking about BSD, I will talk about Linux first. No one will deny the Linux is dominating the world now. I can give you two examples. The first is. Now, the top 500 supercomputers in the world are all run Linux operating system. You can see this picture. So, sorry. The second example is about my previous employer, Hewlett Packard Enterprise. The HPE has its own Unix operating system, which is called HP Unix. But I think now it put the main focus on Linux operating system. I think it's the same situation as Oracle and Solaris. Oracle acquired the Sun and it owns Solaris. But I think Oracle also put more effort on Linux now. So why did I begin to use BSD operating systems? Actually, there is no special reason. I'm just tired of Linux is everywhere. For my company's laboratory, all the servers are run Linux. So I want to try something else, some different things. The first BSD flavor I began to get my hands dirty on is FreeBSD. It begins in January 2016.
FreeBSD runs on Mac, but the hardware supports various devices, for various keyboards.
I install virtual machine. I install FreeBSD on a virtual machine and played it. The byproduct of this process is I write a simple manual, which notes my experience of using FreeBSD. Then I dived into OpenBSD last year. In fact, I first learned OpenBSD in 2014. Because of the news that the OpenBSD community even lacks the money for pay the electricity bill. And I remember that news discussion in the internet forums, such as what's the correct method for open source community to live or earn money. Also, at that time, I knew OpenBSD is famous for its security. So after usage of FreeBSD and OpenBSD, I decided to do some contributions of for BSD operating systems. In Linux, there is a neat command called lscpu, which can use to display CPU information. But for BSD operating system, unfortunately, it doesn't has the out-of-box command like this. And it needs to use such as DMI decode or to read the message log to get the CPU information. So I decided to implement myself. Okay, let's enter the second part of this topic. I will introduce lscpu for Linux. So this is the lscpu display display the information on Linux box. It can display what architecture of this CPU and how many CPUs in the server, and such as CPU speed and cache size, and the features CPU support. There is an interesting concepts: the physical CPU and the logic CPU. The physical CPU number is equal to your socket number. So in my this machine, it can only have one physical CPU. But for logic CPU, every socket can have many cores. And for the CPUs such as Intel, it can support hyper-thread for every core. So the logic CPU number is actually it's the thread number times cost number times the socket number. So we can see in this machine, we have two logical CPUs. How does lscpu work on Linux? The source code is here. Actually, there is no rocket science. It's just read the information from the pseudo file system, proc, and sys. Okay. So this is a little fancy. We can see the proc CPU info has provided the detailed information of the CPUs in current server. And what lscpu do is just read these files and pass it and display it. But unfortunately, it's removed from BSD operating system, at least on FreeBSD and OpenBSD. That means if I want to implement, I need to use other methods. Okay, let's enter the kernel part of this topic, how I implement lscpu for BSD operating systems. The first tool I use is using sysctl library function. This can be used to get or set system information. The name parameter specifies what information you want to get or set. And the old p points to the old p is used to store the current information. And the new is used to store the new information you want to set. this is an example of using sysctl, and it's used to get the CPU number or CPU count in current server. We can see the MIB specify we want to get the CPU numbers. And this CPU number variable is used to store current CPU number. Because we don't need to set the new CPU number, so the last two parameters are null or zero. Okay. I have compiled it before, so you just need to execute the program. We can see the CPU number of machine is 2. But the problem of sysctl is it can only get limited information, and not all BSD flavors support the same operation. So this means it can get very general, such as the architecture and the byte order and the CPU number. These three items are only supported in BSD. So to get more detailed information of CPU, I need other methods. In x86 architecture, it provides a CPU ID instruction. This instruction can get exhausted CPU information. For people interested in CPU ID, you can visit this wiki page. The compilers such as GCC and Clan provide a CPU ID marker, and we can use it to get information which we are interested. The GCC source code is here. It means execute the CPU ID instruction. The input parameter is level, and the output output is a solid A, B, C, and D. So the tightest work of this process is I need to read the Intel and AMD documents to pass the return value. Intel and AMD have some difference in the CPU ID instructions, so I need to pass it carefully. So this is an example of using CPU ID. The input parameter is 0, and the output will stored in EX, EBX, ECS, and EDX. This is used to get the vendor information of current CPU. So let's check it. Okay, the program can get the vendor information of the CPU is Genio Intel. For every software, the is a very important phase. So to testing, I install OpenBSD and FreeBSD in virtual machine. The host is Linux, and I will compare the results with lscpu output in host and virtual machine to check whether my code has bugs or not. The other thing is because I only have Intel CPU, and some developers have tested on AMD CPU and other BSD distributions such as Dragonfly BSD, NetBSD, etc. So the current status of this project is the source code. Source code is here, and some developers creating the ports for FreeBSD, OpenBSD, or MiddleBSD. So I think if someone interested in this project can use it directly. But the limitation is mainly support x86 families. But for other architectures such as ARM, Spark, or whatever, the information can only be get from sysctl library function. Because it lacks the in like CPU ID instructions like Intel or AMD. Okay, it's time to wrap up this presentation. Generally speaking, the developing lscpu program is a rewarding program. I have learned 2 points. The first is how to develop a BSD program. The second thing is I get a lot of CPU knowledge, especially for x86 architecture. The other thing is free and open source software has changed the world. So I think everyone can contribute to it, such as coding, testing, or donating, and so forth. That's all. Thank you.